Now, in exercise 2.7, we are going to consider the question number second. And for this question number second, we have to find out the division. Here, we are going to find out the division of fractional number and numbers like 10, 100, 1000, and so on. 10, 100, 1000, and so on. So, if you observe very properly these numbers, if you observe these numbers very properly, then you can find that if we consider the number 10, then in the number 10, 10 is there. Then in 100, 20 are there. Then in 1000, 30 are there, and so on. So if we increase the number of zeros are going to be increased. So in 10,000, there should be 4 zeros. Next one is 1 lakh, 5 zeros, 10 lakh, 6 zeros, and so on. So this cycle is going to be continued. But here we are going to deal with only first three numbers. Generally, we are going to dealing with only first three numbers, 10, 100, and 1000. And in each case, you have to consider the number of zeros. We have to consider the number of zeros which are present in that particular number. Now here, we are going to consider the first sub-question now. So we are going to understand that division by example directly. So here, the first example is like this. 4.8 divided by 10. 4.8 divided by 10. That is the first example. So here, we are going to divide this 4.8 with the help of 10. We are going to divide it with the help of 10. Now, here, actually, if we consider the fact regarding this example, now here actually two ways are there. That means we can solve this example in two ways. So the first way that already we had seen. What is the first way here? The first way is that we have to ignore the decimal point for a temporary purpose. We have to ignore the decimal point for a temporary purpose, and then we have to perform our calculation. This is the first step. But the second step is that we can ignore directly that. That means second step is that we can shift that decimal point. Directly we are going to shift that decimal point. So here we are going to use only that second method only, because that one is very easy as compared to the first method, in which first of all we have to remove the decimal point, then we have to perform the division, then whatever be the answer is there, in that we have to again bring that decimal point. So this is little bit lengthy process in this case only. That means for such a type of example where we are dividing the decimal number with the help of 10, 100, or 1000, or 10,000, like this. So here we are dividing it by 10. So therefore, we are not going to use that first method. Directly, we are going to use the second method. And in the second method, we are going to only shift the decimal point either towards the left side or either towards the right side. So here we will revise the concept from the exercise 2.6. In exercise 2.6, we had dealing with multiplication. So suppose this example is from previous case, then it should be like this, 4.8 into 10, like this example is there. So here, if multiplication is there, then in that case, we are shifting that decimal point to the right side. We are shifting that decimal point to the right side by how many number of digits? Number of digits equals to number of zeros in that number. So here in 10, only 10 is there. So in that case, we are shifting the decimal point to the right side by one digit. And therefore, this answer is becoming 48, because that decimal point is shifted from after 4 to the after 8 because we are shifting it by one digit. So we are getting our answer. So in the same manner, we are going to obtain the division also. Only the difference is that here we have to shift the decimal point to the right side, because in multiplication we are shifting that decimal point to the right side, and here we are going to shift it to the left side. So that is only difference in multiplication and division. So in multiplication we are shifting that decimal point to the right side, but here we are going to shift that decimal point to the left side only. So here that decimal point is present between 4 and 8. So we have to bring that decimal point before 4. Before that 4, we have to bring that decimal point. So we had shifted that decimal point. And before 4, no digit is present. So therefore, we can put that 0. We know that if digit is not present, then we are using 0. Instead of that digit, we are using 0. And therefore, 4.8 divided by 10 is going to be 0.48. And how we had obtained this? Only we have to shift the decimal point to the left side by one digit, because in 10, only 10 is there. In 10, only 10 is there. So therefore, we are going to shift that decimal point to the left side by only one digit. This is the first example. Now we will see all the examples, then you are going to get idea about how to shift that decimal point. Now here the second example is 52.5 divided by 10. 52.5 divided by 10 is our number. So here I am going to indicate that numbers here in large font, so you can able to see that decimal point. So here 52.5. So here decimal point is present after 52. Decimal point is present after 52. And we are going to divide it by number 10. We are going to divide it by 10. We are going to divide it by 10. And in 10, only 10 is there. So therefore, we are going to shift this decimal point to the left side. We are going to shift that decimal point to the left side because division is there. If multiplication is there, then you can shift that to the right side. But here, as the division symbol is there, so therefore we have to shift that decimal point to the left side by one digit. By one digit. So we have to count that digit. We are going to shift that decimal point after one digit. That means it will shifted before 2 and after 5. So therefore, after shifting that decimal point, we are getting the final answer as 5.25. We are getting the final answer as 5.25. So here what we had done, we had only shifted the decimal point by one digit to which side? To the left side. Because how many zeros are there? Only 10 is there. So therefore, we have to shift it by one digit only. Now we will see another example. 0.7 divided by 10. 0.7 divided by 10. Again, what we had done here? Again, we had shifted that decimal point to the left side. So here, that decimal point is shifted before 0 because 0 is present towards the left side. So therefore, we have shifted that decimal point before 0 because we have to shift it by one digit. So therefore, we are getting the final answer as 0.07. We are getting 0.07, which is the final answer after shifting the decimal point by one digit to the left side. So in this way, we are going to only shift the decimal point to the left side when we are dividing it by 10, 100 or 1000. And how many digits should be shifted? The number of digits equals to the number of zeros in that 10, 100 and 1000. So in this way, we had solved these first three examples. Okay. Now here in the example number 4, same type of example is given. 33.1 divided by 10. 33.1 divided by 10. So again, we are dividing that given number with the help of 10. That means we are dividing it by 10. So therefore, here we have to shift that decimal point to the left side by how many digits? By single digit. That means by one digit, because in 10 only one zero is there. So therefore, we are going to shift the decimal point to the left side by only one digit. We are going to shift that decimal by only one digit. So now it is present after 33. So while shifting to the left side by one digit, then that will be shifted between 3 and 3. That will be shifted between 3 and 3. So therefore, final answer is 3.31. Final answer is 3.31. So this is the fourth example. Then next one is fifth example. 272.23 divided by 10. 272.23 divided by 10. So again, same steps we have to follow. We have to just shift that decimal point to the left side. By how many digits again? By one digit only, because in 10, only single digit is there. So we are going to shift that decimal point by one digit only to the left side. So therefore, it is coming after 27. So therefore, we are getting the final answer as 27.223, which is the final answer for the fifth question from the question number second. So in this way, we can solve the examples in which we are dividing it by 10. Okay.